Over 10 trucks carrying cattle were flagged off from Akurukwe checkpoint. On them were 240 heads of cattle, which were impounded from non-compliant herdsmen. They were being kept at the government holding grounds in Lakang, Laima, Gotlungalang, Atiak, among other places. The animals were loaded from the district holding ground in Lakang sub-county in Amuru district by owners who never wanted their animals transported to Gotapoyo sub-county in Nwoya district. The holding grounds were gazetted for Gulu, Amuru and Nwoya district. The flagged off trucks were fully guarded by police. Each truck had an officer on board to escort the cattle up to Karuma along heavily guarded routes. The herdsmen, who were in fear of losing their animals if relocated to the government holding ground in Gotapoyo sub-county, decided to relocate their animals to Masindi and Luwero districts.
The government land, I really don't know. Because they are saying there are options of auctioning our animals.
Odong Latek is the Amuru resident district commissioner. He explains that they will drive up to 3,000 heads of cattle owned by non-compliant herdsmen out of Amuru district this month.
140 heads of cattle which have left Amuru for different destinations. As instructed by the president, owing to the executive order, anybody who has not complied to the presidential requirements of ensuring you have a fence of 4 strands of wires, of ensuring that you have water inside the fence, of ensuring that the proportion of animal is equal to the proportion of the land size, must leave.
Noah Manya Joshua has been in the district for the last 3 years, grazing his animals in Lakang sub-county. He is appealing for more time in order for them to complete the fencing of their land as required by the government.
Yes, I was intercepted yesterday, but one, unfortunately, I thought it was 3 days to prepare myself and go, but I found my animals loaded. It's unfortunate. My animals are 300.
300. From which area?
From Amur, Lakang sub-county. But I understand some don't follow the rules, but some follow the rules and we are intercepted. We beg for more grace period. We beg for cooperation.
Those transporting the animals have cited bad roads and high fuel costs as challenges affecting the transportation of animals from the government holding ground.
But the problem that we are finding, one problem is that the road from Guru, Babo Highway, to Otwe, from Otwe to Kororo, it's impassable road. So far now, two trucks have gone down the diff because of the bad road. And the frames are breaking down, but we have nothing to do. We have to work for our motherland, Uganda. The next thing is fuel. Fuel is very expensive, and people don't have what? The Valalo don't have enough money.
The Valalo were given an ultimatum by the president to fence their plots or leave Acholi sub-region. Story compiled by Danish Oti for the news in Amuru district.